Mom wouldn't hold me like other mothers I saw on television. She didn't like to be touched or touch anyone else. She would say, "Stop that, you won't be all right," with a slight pat on the back if I fell down or experienced one of the many emotional bruisings that causes children to cry. After years of getting no response from Mom to my crying, I conditioned myself to cry silently and later not to cry, or for that matter, not show any emotion in any circumstance. However, since May 12, 2013, I've cried more than any other time in my life. As my husband Jimmy turned off the 10 o'clock news, I realized my sister Vicky hadn't called today. Since we lived over 150 miles from each other and Vicky didn't use social media or texting, phone calls were our main source of communication. I sat in bed and knew I couldn't sleep till I spoke to her. I called her. The phone rang. And her 30-year-old son, Kenny, answered. "Where's Vicky at?" I said. "Where the hell you think she is?" "Stoddard County Jail," he replied. "What for?" I asked. "She killed Chris," he replied, as if my sister murdering her husband was common knowledge, something I should have already known.